Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss sets for JavaScript. What is a set? A set is a collection of distinct values without using keys. And in this video, I'm going to discuss the way to add and delete values from a set. Also, I'm going to set up a prefilled set. That means I just use one statement to produce a set. And the video is also going to tell you the way to show the values of a set. There are two ways of doing so. The first one is to use for loops, and the other one is to use the forEach method. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I have a title and a heading. And the JavaScript file is linked to this HTML file. And the JavaScript file is called myscript.js, which is stored in the JS folder. Now let me go to the JavaScript file. Since I want to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict on the first line of the JavaScript file. And now I'm going to discuss a set. What is a set in JavaScript? A set is a collection of distinct values without using keys. A set doesn't really have to include the indices of an element. And of course, the order of entry of the elements into a set is unimportant. Now let me create a set. So this is the first line of creating a set. I have to say new set provided with a pair of empty parentheses, and the variable name of this set is called set of colors. Now I want to add a string to the set, and I can use the add method, and the content of the string is enclosed by a pair of double quotation marks or single quotation marks. Now I have already added three more strings to my set. So now altogether I have four elements in my set. Since a set only allows distinct values, what would happen if I add a repeated element in my set? I can show you the situation right now. Now I've added a string called black, which is already included in the previous insertion of elements into my set. So according to the code here, it seems like we have five elements added using the add method. So we may think that there are five elements, two of which are repeated. And I'm going to show you the way to delete an element from a set. I just used the delete method. Delete blue means that I want to delete the element which is a string called blue. So if we count the number of additions and number of deletions, it seems like we have four elements. But is it really the case? I can show you the answer now. I can show the number of elements in a set by using the .size command. Save. Reload. You can see that I have only three elements. Why three? Because the second string called black isn't included. So I have 1, 2, 3 elements. And also I have already deleted the string which is called blue. So the blue element is already deleted. So altogether I have just these three elements. That's why I have 3 as the size of the set. So I can do the double checking to see whether the blue string has already been deleted from my given set. The way is to use the has method of a set. So does the set has this particular string? Let us see. Save. Reload. Yes, the answer is false, because this string is already deleted by using the delete method. So we have introduced the way to add and delete elements, and we have to notice that sets would ignore repeated values. Okay. In addition to adding elements into a set one by one, I can put all the values stored in an array into a set directly. So let us see how we can do it. So this is just the way to provide an array into a set so that the elements in the array will be stored in a set. So now I have a set of vegetables, and I'm going to store three elements in a given array, and these elements would be stored in the elements of a set. And now I'm going to give you the way to show the elements of a set. Since a set doesn't use keys to remember the order of insertion, the keys in sets actually serve at the same purpose as values. So let me demonstrate this idea to you now. So you can see that I can loop over all the keys of the set, and I let the content be a variable called vegetable. And if I'm going to use the alert window to show all the variables contained in the set of vegetables.keys, actually I will just show up all the elements in that particular set. Save. Reload. First, I get cabbage. Second, I get lettuce. And third, I get broccoli. So since a set doesn't use keys to remember the order of insertion, when I use keys method, I'm just showing the set content. Of course, I can also use the values method of a set to show the values directly. So let me demonstrate it to you now. So now I use values instead of keys as the methods of showing the content of the set. So I will get the same result. Save. Reload. Yes, cabbage first, lettuce second, and broccoli the last. So we can see that the keys and values methods are serving the same function, which is to show the content of a set. Actually, a set also has another method called entries. And if we use entries, the entries method will give us both the keys and values altogether. But since in a set, both keys and values are the same, it just means that the elements will be repeated. It just means that the content will be shown twice. So let me show you this situation. So I use the entries method in order to show the content of a set. But since both the keys and values are treated as the same in a set, I'm just going to show the content twice. Save. Reload. Yes, cabbage. So the first one is similar to a key, and the second one is similar to a value. But since a set only has values, the keys are just repeated as the value. And the second one is lettuce. The third one is broccoli. So the purpose of repeating the value as a key is that it is going to mimic the key value pairs for maps. Remember that in JavaScript, when I use the entries method to a map, I'm able to show the key and value altogether. But in a set, we cannot do so because the key doesn't exist in a set. So in order to mimic the key and value pairs for maps, the entries method for a set is just repeating the value as the key. What would happen if I don't use entries, values, or keys? In this case, I'm just showing the keys or values. So let me demonstrate it to you now. Thank you. So you can see that I don't use any methods of set to this variable called set of vegetables. Save. Reload. Yes, the first one is cabbage, shown here. The second one is lettuce. The third one is broccoli. So you can see that either the keys or the values is used when I don't include it at the end of the set variable. Okay. In order to show the content of a set, I can also use the forEach method. And let me demonstrate the use of the forEach method now. So this is the way of using the forEach method. The forEach method accepts a certain arrow function. So the arrow function is going to show the value of that particular set called set of vegetables. Okay, and the use of the forEach method is like this. The second argument in the callback function is not used. That means this one is not used. So I can just call it a certain variable called repeated value, which can have another name as you like. Even though this variable is not used, it is still suggested to remake the second argument to mimic the case of arrays. In the forEach method of arrays, we can include the item, the index, and the array content, which is just an analogy to the set in my current case. And of course, the item in an array is just mimicking the value of a set, and the index of an array has no such analogy in a set. That's why this variable is not used in the forEach method of a set. But still, it is suggested to include it so that I can just mimic the situation in arrays, like this one. Okay? So let me see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, cabbage is the first one, shown here. The second one is lettuce. The third one is broccoli. So the forEach method is going to show the value by using this particular arrow function, because this arrow function is trying to do the alert window all the time for each of the values in a given set. Okay. So this video has already discussed a lot of things about sets. We have known the way to use the set keyword, and I'm able to do the addition and deletion of a set. Remember that the order of entries is unimportant in a set. Also, a set only allows distinct values. Okay. And I've also talked about a way to set up a set in just one statement like this one. And I'm also able to loop over the keys which are treated as the values of a set, the values themselves, as well as the entries. So I'm also able to loop over the elements in the set by using these approaches. And I'm also able to use the forEach method to help me loop over the content of a set. And the format of the forEach method for a set is quite similar to that of an array, by including the value, the repeated value, and the set itself. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.